once was a hermit, but inside I was yearning just to take off the mask and see the light. And it was you who made me see. You gave me hope and set me free. And yeah, I know I've been a little slow, but hey, I'm good to go. Hey, I'm good to go.
Join me. This summer has flown by. We have made some major changes to our life, and I guess I want to share them with you. Start with here at the cabin. We were able to see moose almost every single day. It was cows with their calves. Cow chased a bull away. We went to Ferry. We love taking our four-wheeler up there. It's paradise here. The mosquitoes aren't as bad there. Plus you get out to the marsh, and then it's pretty bad.
It's recording absolutely.
Oh yeah. Chalk or Limestone Canyon is one of my favorite places to go when we go to Ferry. I think we always stop here. But there in Ferry, we found this other beaver lodge that had this couple, and they were very friendly. I mean, I was maybe 5 feet away, and he did not care one bit. He just sat there and was gnawing on the wood, where the female, she minded a little more, but not too much because I was still like 10 feet away from her.
Thank you.
hiking, lots of that. Mosquitoes, lots of mosquitoes. We went down the Valdez a couple times. One time we were hiking up at, I think it's John Memorial Trail. It's near the hatchery. And there was, it was just beautiful, but there was this bear. He was off in the trees right beside the trail, or it's more of a maintenance road, but they call it a trail. And, but we were hiking, we were getting ready to cross the bridge, and he came out to the bridge. So he was wanting to come over when we were wanting to pass to leave. So we backed up onto where this, where the trail veers, where you can go to an overlook, and to see if he'll pass. But he started, and he was a little bit afraid, which is a good thing for a bear. We just sat down and waited and waited and waited, and eventually he got to the end of the bridge. He jumped off the edge where the bridge was and went down into the rocks, but it was just, it was an incredible experience, and I was a little afraid, to be honest. And then we took the Lulu Belle Charter, which, that was the game changer. That was when I knew we needed a boat. I get seasick, not my thing, kind of boring, but it's different here in Alaska. You see so much wildlife. Things ready to sail, because we knew we weren't in any financial situation to go out and buy a boat right then. But we got home and we pulled down all our assets. So we were like, does this need to go? Does this need to go? Does this need to go? Can this go? And we realized there was a few things that we really could do without, and so we sold them. And surprisingly enough, it didn't take long to sell at all. Maybe it's because Alaska, maybe it's because COVID, that pandemic, everybody's wanting a recreational RV. I don't know, but the RV sold, and the other things did too, and so we were excited. We were like, let's get this boat. And we went back down to Valdez to look at the boats. Everything was out of our price range. Everything. Except for this one boat. And it was very cute, but it was a planer. And what that means is it goes really fast and it rocks and rocks. And so if I'm already having a problem with seasickness, it's not a good idea. But it was a consideration that we considered for the entire month of June. And we spoke to someone with a lot more knowledge than we have, and he suggested that we go with a bigger boat. And he also suggested that we start looking in Seattle, because you get more boat for your money. I guess that's how it goes. More boat for your money. That's what we did, and we ended up with the boat that we got, and it has some work that needs to be done, but nothing that's something that we can't do. It's going to take money to fix, and so that's where we're at now, and the journey begins.